I really hope that no one judges me and my work based on my personal lifestyle. What's your hurry? Please don't eat and run.
Just keep us informed. We'll call you later.
Loyal Studios.
What he said.
Go, go!
Eyes ahead.
All right, she's gonna do this thing called forcing the close-up, which means she's gonna pause. When that happens, I want you to zoom right in on her, all right? Don't miss a single thing. You, I don't wanna miss a single word, all right? Otherwise it's your ass. Do not fuck this up, either of you. Hey!
Hello!
Hey, man, how's it going?
Dawn?
Mind if we...
Yeah, sure.
Bueno. Seriously, Mary. Please. You need to tell everybody.
What do you mean, blah?
It's the truth.
I will.
Okay.
Oh, no, I'm... but... Have you got any vodka?
We can't talk about any of this?
Correct.
You can't even mention it?
Absolutely not.
Well, Jesus, Bobby, what's left for me to ask her then? Her favorite color?
This is what she wants to talk about. This is what she doesn't want to talk about. Look. If you don't want to do this, tell me now while the driver's still outside. Here's an idea. Why don't you ask her about her single? Or her new album?
She's gonna get asked these questions eventually, and if she does, it's not gonna be in a controlled environment. It's not gonna be under the force of a contract, right? They're gonna ask her with force. And then they're not gonna leave her alone until she answers them. So, wouldn't it make sense for me to ask her these questions here, now, in a... that place of safety, you know, with somebody you trust. Come on, Bobby. Bobby, do the right thing.
Firstly, it's not me who wants it, it's her. And secondly, don't ever bring up our history again.
A closed interview, please. Thank you. relax. We just want the real you. That's all.
All right. How we doing, guys? You good?
Ready to go.
Does the Springfield interview take one?
So, you've had quite an interesting year.
If you say so, yeah.
Dusty, what were some of your biggest challenges, segueing from being a big ballad singer into trying to become a soul queen?
Stop, please. Can you just stop that, please? Yeah. Let me see your note.
All right.
Okay, this is wrong. We can just delete this.
It's all there, black and white. Everything is already in the contract.
This is wrong.
It's a television interview. I reserve. How is it wrong?
It's wrong. I'm not a soul queen.
This is the material that was agreed upon earlier. It's in the contract on the desk.
I'm not a soul queen.
You're not a soul queen. You produced a soul album.
One album.
One album? It's.
I produced one album. You better get your shit straight. You're misinforming your viewers.
From the record, there will be no mention of Soul Queen.
Okay.
Never again.
Camera speed. Sound speeding.
The viewers want to know, what were you thinking, what were you planning when you decided to pursue this particular genre? What were your intentions?
Well, where to begin? I've always had a special place in my heart for American gospel. And I knew I'd eventually try it. I just didn't think it'd be this soon. So I had just finished with the success of the song Look of Love, which was such a powerful song. And I was so grateful to be a part of that. And I thought, there it is, there's my transition into soul and gospel.
Were there any specific obstacles that you had to overcome?
There was actually quite a bit of doubt surrounding the whole project from the beginning. And then I thought, I had a glimpse. There was one instance when I knew it would work.
Direct from our newsroom in Washington, this is the CBS Evening News with Walter Cronkite.
Good evening. Dr. Martin Luther King, the apostle of nonviolence in the civil rights movement, has been shot to death in Memphis, Tennessee. Police have issued an all-points bulletin for a well-dressed young white man seen running from the scene.
Dusty. Post from London.
Bloody time. Thank you, man.
Dusty, do what you can for us. Hope all is well. Expecting company. We've made more tea.
Oh, look what the cat dragged in. Please come in.
Hey, Duff. Hey, Dusty. Oh, sorry to bust in on your Thursday night like this. But, we have some exciting news to talk to you about.
Well, obviously. Otherwise, you would have given me a ring on the telly. What's going on?
We think we've got your third song from Memphis.
I think we found the hit that you're looking for.
This is going to be track 3.
Why does it say Aretha Franklin on it?
Look, Dust, I'm going to be honest with you. Aretha passed on the song. The song was originally written for her.
Why'd she pass on the song?
Things haven't moved as fast as maybe we would have liked them to for her to release a song of this nature. A song with this type of religious theme on top of a gospel track. unfortunately, America's just not ready for. No, I mean, you're absolutely right. We've been looking for a song for this album that's going to be a hit, and I think this is that song. As a matter of fact, this could even be a single.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's going to work.
Dusty, you ask us to help you with your relaunching of your career, and we really think this song is going to make it, make the Memphis album.
I can sing the song, but I can't sing this song like Aretha.
You know, things work out. We've talked to Jerry Wexler. Wexler's on board. You know, he wrote the song, and you were his second, you were his first choice after Aretha, and he is excited. I mean, I wish you could have heard him on the phone, excited to have you on board.
We all are. We're ready.
Well, look at the weather out here. We came all the way in this rain to hand off your Grammy. If we release this track with you and your voice, we believe it's lightning. What do you say?
All right. All right, I'll trust you.
So just like that?
It's nice when people owe you things.
But I need you to trust me on something.
Anything, sure, yeah. Dusty.
I've got a dear friend who just recently joined a band. I need you to sign them.
Well, we can't really work that way, Dusty. I mean...
What do you mean it doesn't work that way? I was referred by a friend, was I not?
Well, I mean, that's different. You were already a known entity, so... I mean, when we think about it that way...
This is quite out of character for me. I would appreciate it if you trust me on this one, as I'm trusting you.
Well, you know, Dusty, if we signed everybody's friend, we'd have, we'd sign everybody.
Dusty, who are these guys? What do they sound like?
Have you heard of Yardbirds?
The new Yardbirds, I think. They're kind of a... bluesy sound. I think they had a few hits. What's going on with them?
They recently broke up. My friend John and the guitar player are doing their own thing now.
What kind of sound do they have? What are they like?
I haven't the faintest idea. But I received a demo today in the post. Did in fact become everything I knew they'd become. I haven't seen John in years. I don't think they knew I had a hand in that. You see, when something moves me, whether I'm a part of it or not, I just want it to. I just have to see it go that way. Do you believe in magic? I mean, real magic. When I was with my brother in the Springfields, we thought, One day someone's gonna find out our tricks. Aretha Franklin passes on a song, and it lands in my lap. That's magic.
So you mentioned earlier that you knew things would start to work out for you when you met with Ahmed and Herb, but were there any other obstacles that you had to overcome? Any?
Of course, there's... How do you mean?
Well, what I mean is, were there any specific issues about being in the public eye that you had to confront?
Well, sure. I remember on the first day, Jerry had pre-recorded most of the song. And, I almost didn't show up.
Where is she?
I wouldn't worry about it. She does her best work when she's late.
Unbelievable.
I'm terribly sorry that I'm late.
Hello, Dusty.
I met Jerry. Hello.
We're all settled. Did you rehearse?
Yeah. I did.
Is there something wrong?
No, the song is magnificent. It's a beautiful song. It's good.
You seem hesitant. Come on, Dusty. We talked about this.
I mean, it's just so different for me. I shouldn't be doing this song.
Dusty, we talked about this. This is your song. You've got some of the best musicians in Memphis here with you. Let's give this a shot. It's going to be good.
People are calling me a closet gay. And now, after this, white woman from Britain comes to the States to sing black people music? The tabloids would love this.
None of that matters,
Dusty. It won't matter. Dusty, years from now, people are gonna sing this song and they're gonna think of you, because it's your baby. Let's make it yours.
All right. Let's do this.
All right. This is Dusty Springfield. Take one.
Preacher's son, and when his daddy would visit, he'd come along. When they gathered round and started talking, Pastor Billy would take me walking. Out through the backyard we go walking. Then he'd look into my eyes. Lord knows, to my surprise, the only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. You see what he was. Yes, he was.
If you would ask someone to describe me after hearing one of my songs, they'd probably say, a black woman, Maybe from the South. The irony is that American culture has got so much to offer artistically, and yet the British artists are at the tip of the sword. And all we did was copy.
Jimi Hendrix. He had to come all the way to London just to break through. Yanks don't know the first thing about talent.
Don't get me wrong, I mean, the Brits have got their problems too. Just for being an outsider looking into the box, you can see it's just a box.
Sorry, that was off topic. I digress. You were saying?
So, the album dropped a little over a year ago. Are you finding success now with this crossover into soul?
Well, the Memphis album, it didn't do as well as we'd hoped. But we remain hopeful.
Why do you think that is? Perhaps an issue of image?
I really hope that no one judges me and my work based on my personal lifestyle. Maybe it's too soon. Let's just let history decide.
I have one more question for you. Dusty, I'm going to ask you a question, and I think it's a question that you've been dying to answer. It's just no one's ever given you the chance to answer it yet.
Dusty, are you a homosexual?
No. I'm not.
Shut it down now!
She's a great singer. She's a great actress, too. Jeez. You know, if she wasn't gay, she wouldn't have anything going for her.
You don't know when to quit, do you? Even when you've lost. You don't know when to quit.
Before me, it's over.
Time we're not a moving thing, and I can make it stay. This love we shared would always be. There'd be no coming day, no morning light above to make me realize our love is over. It's over.
What?
It's over.
Jimi Hendrix passed away.
Willie and Laura Mae Jones were neighbors a long time back. They live right down the road from us in a shack just like our shack. The people work the land together and we learn to count on each other. When you live off the land, you don't have the time to think about another man's color. The cotton was high and the corn was growing fine. Another time. Sit out on the front porch in the evening when the sun went down. Yeah. Willie would play and the kids would sing and everybody would mess around. Daddy bring out his guitar and play on through the night. Yeah. Every now and then old Willie would grin and say, hey, you play all right. Made me feel so good. I remember the best times of all, the Saturday came around. Y'all would stop by Willie's house and say, do y'all need anything from town? He said, no, well, why don't y'all stop on the way back through? And I'll get Laura Mae, yeah, to cook up some barbecue. And you know that's good. The cotton was high and the corn was growing fine. You say, well, another time. Oh, the years rolled past the land and took back what they gave it. We all knew we had to move if we were gonna make a living. So we all moved off and went about a separate ways. Sure was hard to say goodbye to Willie and Laura Mae. Oh yeah,
the cotton was high and the corn was growing fine.
You see, well, but that was another place and another time. I remember the way
the cotton was high and the corn was growing fine.
You looked so fine, but that was another.